U.S. coastal counties are home to 129 million people, nearly 40% of the nation's population, and coastlines worldwide are changing.
Sea level is rising along the entire mainland United States coast, but it's rising at different rates. So the West Coast is rising slower, the Gulf, Louisiana, and Texas is rising the fastest.
Dr. Molly Mitchell is one of the scientists behind the U.S. Sea Level Report Card Project.
There are a lot of different processes that affect sea level rise. So that includes things like land subsidence, so the sinking of land. And land subsidence can be driven by geological processes, but it can also be driven by groundwater extraction or gas and oil extraction. The melting of the ice sheets, which is happening faster than had been anticipated 5 to 10 years ago, is contributing to the acceleration of the rates.
And since 1955, heat energy stored in the oceans has skyrocketed, causing thermal expansion. Scientists say that this expansion is responsible for a third to a half of the current sea level rise. NOAA estimates that by 2050, Gulf Coast sea level will rise on average 14 to 18 inches, the East Coast 10 to 14 inches, and the West Coast 4 to 8 inches. It may not sound alarming, but we're already seeing changes.
The biggest impact that people are seeing right now from rising sea level is an increase in sunny day flooding, where these high tides come in and now they're covering roads. And it's maybe just for a few hours, but it disrupts traffic. And as sea level is rising, those are becoming more frequent.
And there's a rising sea level side effect that you can't see. It's been called a slow poison.
The other thing we're seeing is a rising groundwater. It impacts things like septic fields. Rising groundwater can bring salt with it. And so that can bring salt into shallow wells. It can affect drinking water. It can bring salt into agricultural fields and affect agricultural production.
Sea level rise can seem like an insurmountable challenge. For some places, it may be. But many communities are taking action now to adapt.
We have really good data about how sea level is changing. And that gives us an opportunity to bring that into our planning and our decision making so that we're not in 30 years or 50 years caught in a crisis, so that we can actually start to prepare now and be ready and be resilient to it.